This problem is a little bit tricky because you have to completely rethink the approach. Previously, we looked at a picture and the one to the left. But when we use an enhanced for loop, we only get to look at one picture at a time. So we have to remember something from the past. The way I've done it is I would remember the rightmost position of the previous picture. Let me show you. I have an enhanced for loop, and when I'm done positioning the picture, I remember its rightmost x value. So when I re-enter the loop with the next picture, then I can position it 10 further than the rightmost x value, and they'll all be spaced apart nicely. What about the first picture? If I start the rightmost x at 0, then the first picture ends up at offset 10. So that's the answer. And now when you look at these two loops, you can see that we can actually merge them. So we do the positioning and drawing in a single loop. That's enough about pictures for right now. Sarah will show you another application of ArrayLists. She'll revisit a class that you've seen in Lesson 3, the Person class that collected friends. At that time, we did it in a less than perfect way by just having one long string of friend names. Now that you know how to collect objects, she'll collect the friends in an ArrayList. All right, over to you, Sarah.